My goodness, I've been uploading bulk magazines for sale from the past, the very past issues. And I'm like, well, oftentimes I'm looking at these magazines and I'm like, they're very gleanful in this decade, in this time frame. And I'm almost finding, well, they're new. You know, they're as new in their design, in their topic, in that situation. So in certain circumstances, we don't have to keep continuing the purchase of brand new in the magazine industry, okay? So what I'm really, really attempting here in this discussion is we're trying to get a sustainable forest industry mandate on magazines, okay? So if it's a sustainable forest product, then that's okay. If it is not a sustainable product, then then yes, we have to run into the disallow. We have to run into that is not happening. You know, if you're a magazine company, you must use a sustainable forest product. It has to be written there on the label, you know, from your suppliers. Right then and there, that will hike the magazines up. We already know this. It'll hike the magazines up. Now, we don't want them hiked up too high, but that's the way it goes. It might put a dent in their sales. Thusly, what it will do, it will enhance their back issues. There's nothing wrong with that. Each company of their own ilk, they can go and repurchase their own magazines and resell them. I never said you to stop you from that action. I mean, if you have expensive tree product on those magazines, get them out there and sell them again. So we're talking about reselling that equipage that you guys have already supplied. So maybe it's not worth the brand new price. Of some of these are $18-$20, you know, maybe it's not worth that brand new price, but maybe Dantria, you can resell it for $15, you know, just go on. And we already have that. We have the backissues.com website out there. We already know that. That's pretty cool. But this is what I'm really trying to get at is the mandate specific of the sustainable forests. We have that listed all over Europe again and again at the lumber stores, very good, very healthy. I have not seen that here in the United States of America. I've not seen that printing sustainable forest product. Not understanding it. Anyway, this is our direction and this is what we have to achieve. That's what we have to achieve. And so if it means, like here, I'm looking at all these interior design magazines. I've got interior design, I've got architecture, architectural lighting, I've got interior sources, I've got lighting dimensions, I've got, I've just got hundreds of them. I've got hospitality design, I've got design, did I say that one? Architectural record and architect and architect and all these different ones and architectural. Well, there was one other one. The interiors. Yeah, there's interiors. Okay. So, yeah. Just a lot of them. Now, obviously, as a business, you're going to want the freshest and the newest, aren't you? But I'm sitting here looking at the interior designs and the architects and all of you, and I'm like, well, no. I've looked through all these magazines, and there are some excellent gatherings from the past, just like you look at a Frank Lloyd Wright building. You know, just excellent gatherings. So let's not throw away this particular resource. So let's hike the magazines up. Let's continue and have sustainable products as the mandate, as the regulatory, as the absolute. So no longer are you allowed to just plow down a field for magazine products here in the United States or anywhere in the European Union. I know I'd love to make that a global statement, But my Constantine is a little limited today. All right. Anyway, thank you for listening. Yeah, I know. I'm subjugated to a blockage here on this line, this system, but that's the way it goes. I've been linked to link. I know. I'm not really sure the reason, but that's the way it goes.